Just by replacing one simple file in Blender's color management folder, you can unlock the potential of OpenColor.io, which comes bundled with Blender already. This merge config does not break compatibility with default Blender, which means you can open your older projects without having to worry about your colors being changed. It includes the default Blender configuration, ACES, FilmLight's TCAMv2, and AGX camera and display transforms. You can find all the links for the sources of the mentioned profiles used in the description below. This does not necessarily make your colors magically look better. It adds the much-needed color profiles for production workflows. Until recently, ACES was my go-to color configuration for Blender, and I wanted to create a clean configuration that I can use. While researching how to create such a config, I realized that ACES is not as robust and as clean-cut as I thought it was. Chris Brejon, I hope I'm pronouncing his name right, has a great article on this that you can check out. Link is in the description. So, I decided to create this merge configuration. It gives you all the options to choose from without adding any weight to Blender. With this color configuration, you will have the option to choose any camera gamma and color space for your textures and use logarithmic or display transforms for your exports. In addition, I've added some film print emulations that I created and exported from DaVinci Resolve. They handle well under non-extreme scenarios, although I want to create better ones in the future. You can find these film print emulations under the Look section. You will also have access to the default contrast options for Blender's Filmic, and you will have two look options to choose from for AGX. To install, simply go to Blender's Color Management folder and pull the contents of the zip that you just downloaded inside. Replace the config.ocio file when it's prompted. Keep in mind that no matter what display, view, or look is selected, your floating point exports like EXRs will be in the rendering space, which is linear Rec 709 by default. If you'd like to use ACCG as your color space, you may simply open the config.ocio file in the notepad and change reference, scene linear, and rendering parameters from linear to linear ACES AP1. Keep in mind that if you do this, all the color values in your older default color managed projects will look too saturated, as Blender still assumes that the RGB values are in sRGB color space. But if you're not opening an older file and creating a new project from scratch, your color picker values and your hex codes that you might bring in from other software will be correct. You get to assign a color space to your textures as well, and by default this is sRGB, so those will remain intact, or you get to choose whatever color space that you want for your textures as well. Another caveat for using ACCG as your rendering space for Blender is that your BlackBody node won't work properly anymore. This is due to Blender calculating its values using Rec 709 color space. In the description, you can find the ACCG BlackBody node network, which you can use to fix this issue. Keep in mind that 6000 Kelvin is pure white in ACCG. There's a long discussion to be had about benefits and downfalls of ACES, which I cannot get into in this video. There's a big forum discussion linked in the description below. All in all, use ACCG if it's required. Please also keep in mind that this merged configuration is experimental. If you stumble upon any strange behavior or want me to include something, let me know by leaving a comment down below. Also, I've tested this configuration with After Effects and Nuke. They seem to be working okay, so you can use it for those as well. I hope you enjoy this configuration, and see you next time.